Mark chapter 4 and verse 35. And the same day, when evening was come, he said unto them, let us pass over unto the other side. And when they sent away the multitude, they took him even as he was in the ship. And there was also with him other little ships. And there was a great storm of wind, and the waves beat in the ship so that it was now flowing. And he was in the hinder part of the ship, asleep on a pillow. And they waked him and said unto him, Master, carest not that we perish? And he arose and rebuked the wind and declared, through the power that has been invested in me through my Father, I command you, peace, be still. And the wind ceased, and there was a great calm. And he said unto them, why are ye so fearful? How is it that you have no faith? And they feared exceedingly and said one to another, what manner of man is this, that even the wind and the seas obeyed him? If I might invite you to hold your Bibles in your hands while we declare the word's declaration, I ask you to repeat after me with assurance, authority, and confidence. This is the living and active word of God. I have what it says I have. I can do what it says I can do. Romans chapter 1 verse 16 tells me, I am not ashamed of the word of God, for it is the power of God to set me free. St. John chapter 15 and the verse 7 declares, if I, Paul Fearon, abide in him, and his words abide in me, I shall ask whatsoever I will, and it shall be done. If you believe that, go ahead and give God a shout of praise. If you believe his word, somebody go ahead and give him a hallelujah praise. Come on, if you believe in his word, somebody go ahead and lift your voices like a trumpet and shout hallelujah to God. Glory to God. If God says it, I believe it, and there is nothing that no one, no demons or devil from hell can stop it. Because if God says it, I believe it. If God says that no weapon that is formed against your sister, it doesn't matter the weapon that is formed, it doesn't matter the weapons that come against you, if God said they can't prosper, then they will not prosper. Are you with me, son? That if God said that every tongue that rise against you in judgment shall be condemned, then so shall it be. Whose report shall you believe? If God says it, come on somebody, I believe it. All I need is a word from God. Somebody go ahead and give him a shout of praise. If you believe that there's power in the word, touch your neighbor and say, neighbor, all I need is a word. I might not have money, but all I need is a word. If God said that you're healed, then you are healed. Somebody go ahead and give God a shout of praise. Glory to God. We bless the name of the Lord. And so because God says it, then I believe that we ought to give God the praise. I believe that we ought to give him now the praise. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5 and the verse 18. In all things give him thanks, because it is the will of God concerning your life. Psalm 100 and the verse 4. Enter in his gates with thanksgiving and into his courts with a praise. Be thankful unto him and bless his name, for the Lord is good. Psalm 34 and the verse 1. I will bless the Lord at all times, and his praise shall continually be in my mouth. O magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt his name together. I was glad, yes, Lord, I was glad when they said unto me, touch your neighbor and say, neighbor, I'm not sad, but I was glad when they said unto me, come, let us go into the house of the Lord. Somebody give him a shout of praise. Somebody give him a praise even now. If you're happy and you know it, somebody go ahead and give him a praise. Come on, high five your neighbor and say, neighbor, I am not sad. I am not sick and depressed, but I am glad. I was glad when they said unto me, come, let us go in the house of the Lord. This is the day, woo, that the Lord has made. So I'm going to rejoice and be glad. He deserved the glory. Storm, God is with you. You may not know it, but you're not alone. You're hurting now, but your morning is coming. Come on, touch your neighbor and say, neighbor. Say, neighbor, if you're robbing God, you need to stop it. Come on, come on, you gotta tell your neighbor. Say, neighbor, if you are robbing God, you need to stop it. And tell your neighbor, I'm not talking about material things now. I'm not talking about your houses and your cars and your money. No, I'm not talking about those things and your clothes. No, I'm not. Tell your neighbor, say, neighbor, say, God doesn't need your house. Say, God doesn't dwell in houses. God dwell in the heavens. And can I tell you this? The writer declares that even the heavens of the heavens can't contain God, because God is bigger than our houses. But what God dwells dwells in. The psalm said that the Lord inhabits the praises of his people. Come on, touch your neighbor and say, neighbor, keep your house. Yes, Lord. Tell your neighbor, say, neighbor, I'm not talking about your cars now, or your buses, or your trucks. Tell them that God doesn't need any transportation to take him around. Yes, Lord, because he is the omnipresent God. He's here, he's there, and he's everywhere at the same time. And that's why David said in the Psalm 139, he said, if you take the wings of the morning and fly into the utmost part of the sea, even there God is. If you make your bed in hell, even there God is. He's in America, and if you check Barbados, he's there at the same time. If you take up your phone and call England, they will tell you that God is there. He's everywhere. Touch your neighbor and say, neighbor, keep your trucks and your buses and your cars and your aeroplane, because God is a transportation all by himself. Say yes. Yes, Lord. Glory to God. Touch your neighbor and say, neighbor, say, neighbor, say, neighbor. God doesn't need your money. So keep your money. You can't serve God and mammon. Don't mix up God with your material stuff. So God doesn't have need of your money. He is Jehovah Jireh. And even if God needs some money, he knows where to find it. Remember when Peter needed money to pay the tax, and Jesus said to him, get your fishing line, man. Yes, Lord. And go down by the seaside and throw that net out. Throw the line out, and the first fish that comes up, you're gonna find money in his mouth. Go pay your tax. Can I tell you that your money is in the fish's mouth? God knows where to get money. God has no need. He is Jehovah Jireh, the God that provides. Tell your neighbor, say, neighbor, keep your clothes, your pants and your jacket suits and your dresses and your broad hat. Keep those, because God doesn't wear clothes. Because God is a spirit. And that's why Jesus said to the woman at the well, he said, God is a spirit. And what God desires from us is true worship. God doesn't need any material things. What God desires is true worship and praise. Can I tell you this also, that God doesn't even need your praise, because the angels, they were created to give him worship and praise. Day and night they bow in his presence with wings folded, giving glory and honor and praises unto him. But one thing I tell you, God desires your praise. Can somebody go ahead even right now and begin to send up a praise in this house? Glory to God. We bless you right where you are. You may be driving, you may be driving in your vehicle now, but go ahead as you focus on the road anyhow, but go ahead and give him the praise. You may be sitting in your room, in your living room. Go ahead. You may be in the, you may be in the hospital right now. Anywhere you are, go ahead and give God a praise. I guarantee you right now that if you begin to give praise, I prophesy right now that if you begin to give God a praise, God is going to show up. His glory is about to come down. If you build an atmosphere, God will come down. The only thing that attracts God is your praise. Nothing else attracts him. Go ahead and give him a praise. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Yes, Father, we bless your name. We glorify you. You're worthy. Mark chapter 4 and verse 35 to 41 tells of an encounter which Jesus and his disciples experienced as they were on a mission. This mission was to bring deliverance to a young man and his family. It was a young man that was bound by demons, legions of devils, for a long while. Young man that was doing well, but for some reason demonic forces has influenced his life to the point where they has possessed him. The Bible said that his parents, his family tried everything to bring deliverance to the young man, but nothing helped. The demons took him and have him living with them among the tombs where only the dead should be. Bible said that they tied him with chains and tied him with ropes, bringing him back home. But each time they took him home, the spirits in him would break the chains and break the ropes and the shackles that bind him. Family was in trouble. Nothing could help. So Jesus was on this mission. It also reminded me of a boy who his father came to Jesus and said, "Lord, from my son was a child, the devil tried to kill him. The spirit that torment him, they would throw him into the fire, spirit of suicide. They would throw him into the water for him to kill himself." So Jesus was on this mission with his disciples, and they were encountered by a storm. The enemy recognized that they were on a mission. The devil said that, "I'm going to stop you from fulfilling this mission, from bringing deliverance to this boy and his family." If you will allow me, before I get into the text, to share with you some of the many storms that we face in our lives every day, daily, monthly, yearly, seasonally. There are many different types of storms. Some examples are windstorm, rainstorm, desert storm, hailstorm, thunderstorms, blizzard storms, tornadoes, hurricanes, cyclone, family storm, marital storms, church division storm, financial storm, job lost storm, sickness storms, and the list goes on. The Bible said while they were on the sea, on their way to bring healing and deliverance to this young man, the devil rose up and decided to stop them with a storm. "Yes, Lord." But touch your neighbor and say, "Neighbor, do you know that God is with me? God is in my storm, and it doesn't matter what the storms are. Glory to God." What causes a storm is the action of warm air rising and cold air sinking. Storms are typically formed when there is a disturbance in the air that creates a portion of lower pressure colliding with a portion of high pressure. They're also caused when a warm mass of air meets a cold mass of air. This causes particles to collide and create storms. There's been a lot of collisions in your life which have resulted in your storms. But this I say, sister, this I say, brother, ride out your storm, because God is with you. It may seem like you're alone, but I said, ride out your storm. Because you're not alone. You're not alone. Glory to God. I know you may be feeling the burden and the pressure, but go ahead and ride out your storm. The Bible said as the wind began to blow, this was a windstorm that came up to stop Jesus. Yes, Lord. The reason why all them storm rising up in your life, it's because the devil know that you have a purpose. The devil know that there is greatness in your life. The devil know that you are the overcomer. And so that's why he's rising up all those storms in your life. But can I tell you, it doesn't matter the storms that are coming. Rise! ride out a storm because God is with you. Stay in the storm because you're going to make it. Touch your neighbor and say, neighbor, I'm going to make it. I'm going to make it. Stay in the storm and ride out your storm. The devil know that you're coming out, and so he's going to rise up all kind of storm. But you got to know this, not because he touched you, he think you're touchable, but you got to let the devil know, not because you touch me, you think that I'm touchable. Tell the devil, I am untouchable, not because you slow me down, you think that I am stoppable, but I am unstoppable. You got to let the devil know, and it doesn't matter the storms that rise against you, I'm going to ride out my storm. Hallelujah. Bible say that Jesus was in the bottom of the ship, sleeping, and the waters and the billows roaring, the waters fill the ship. The disciples run to him and said, Master, care us not that we perish. But Jesus stood up. And they rebuke the storm with authority. And he said, peace be still. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Even now, doesn't matter the storm you're going through. We have what is called the rainstorm. The rainstorm. It comes with a lot of rain, and the intention and the mission of the rainstorm is really to cause a flood. Writers say that when it rains, it pours. Storm clouds rise and billows roar when it rains. Right now, there are those of you that are experiencing your rainstorm, and it seems like your rain ain't coming to an end. The sun is gone in, and there's no brightness in your life. Everything seems dull and gloomy. And that's what the rain does. When the rain falls, after much rain, then it brings the flood. But I hear the writer said in Isaiah 43 verse 2, though you pass through the flood, they shall not overflow you, because I am with you. Right now you may be experiencing the rainstorm, and the floods of life is against you. But ride out the storm, because God is with you. There is the storm that is also called the desert storm. Yes, Lord. When the desert storm hits you, the desert storm, it comes with wind and heat. Are you with me, somebody? There's a lot of heat. When the desert storm begin to blow, it leaves you desolate. It leaves you dry. Have you ever been in a place where it seems like you're going through the desert storm, and every era of your life you feel dry? You feel like you're not going nowhere. You pray, but it seems your prayer is bouncing back. You're talking to God, but it feels like you're so far away from him. It is the desert storm. It is leaving you dry. Are you with me? There are those of you who have experienced some heated times in your life. Stranger things keep happening, and you're wondering, God, why are these things happening? It seems like the host of hell is against you. But I hear Peter, he said in 1 Peter 4 verse 12, he said, think it not strange concerning the fiery trials which has come to try me, though some stranger things happen. But he said, you should rejoice and be exceedingly glad. Can I tell somebody, even now, you may be going through your desert storm, but come on, somebody, go ahead and rejoice. Rejoice. I hear Isaiah also says that when you go through the fire, it shall not burn you, because I, God, I am with you. Say yes. If you believe that God is with you, go ahead and say yes. Give him a praise right now. I know God is with you. It may feel you're alone, but remember that God is with you. Glory to God. Hallelujah. You have what is called the hail storm. The hailstorm is a storm that fragments of ice falls from the skies. It normally results from a thunderstorm. Whenever time a thunderstorm occurs, you can always look out because the possibility that there's going to be a hailstorm at some point. The hailstorm is one that will hurt you, but the only time you will be safe is when you're still on the inside. Are you with me, Church of God? Are you with me, somebody? Can I tell you right now, stay under God. Stay under the protection of Almighty God. Because if you're outside, then when the hails begin to fall, you're going to be in trouble. Are you with me? Stay with God. And that's why the writer said, when the Apostle Paul was heading into Rome as a prisoner, the Bible said that the storm rose up against him and the sea became rough. I believe the devil wanted to kill Paul. Are you with me, somebody? The reason why these many storms are coming up against you, it is because the devil is trying to kill your purpose. The devil is trying to stop you. But hear me, I tell that devil that I'm going to ride on my storm, even on broken pieces. I'm going to make it. And so Paul said to them, do not jump ship. Can I declare those of you right now, you may be at a point in your life where you have been going through your storm and it seems like it ain't getting better. It seems everything you try ain't coming out and you want to jump ship. Stay with God. Stay in the ship. I challenge you to stay in the ship, because even as Paul declared, even on broken pieces, you're going to make it. Stay. Ride out the storm. Ride out your storm, because God is with you. Glory to God. Stay with God. Stay in the church. Can I tell you, brother? Can I tell you, sister? Those of you that are experiencing the turmoils and the billows, stay in the church. It is in the church that you will find deliverance. The only place that you will get deliverance. The only place, glory to God, that you will get your breakthrough. I heard Jesus said to Simon, he said, up on this rock I build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail. And what's where you're bound in earth, it's bound in heaven. Stay with God. I declare even right now, it doesn't matter the storms that you're going through. Stay with God. Stay with God. All hell may be breaking loose. Everything you try seems like it's not working. But stay with God. Stay with God, mother. Stay with God, father. Young man, stay with God, because God is gonna come through for you. He is with you in the storm. Glory to God. He is with you. He is with you. He said he will never leave you nor forsake you. So stay with him. Stay with him. Stay with God. Glory to God. You're not alone. You're not alone, but God is with you. He is with you. Stay in the ship. Do not give up on God. Do not jump ship. You may feel at a point in your life that you want to backslide, but stay with God. There is what is called the thunderstorm. The thunderstorm is also called the electrical storm. This comes with much wind, strong wind, and heavy rain, thunder and lightning. And in the storm, one can become electrocuted. So many of our brothers and sisters, you've been experiencing this kind of storm in your life. Glory to God. Where you've been experiencing the floods, the rains, the shockings, the tornado, This is a violent, rotating column of air extending from a thunderstorm. The mission of the tornado is to steal, kill, and destroy. It will take everything in its path. You have the storm, which is called a hurricane. In many parts of the world, they call it a cyclone. It is the worst kind of storm, the hurricane, the cyclone. Most dangerous. Why? Because it lasts up to 1 week. And it spreads up to 600 miles across. It comes with heavy rain, winds, lightning, thunder, and flooding. The cyclone is a kind of storm that it works both anti-clock and clockwise. The storm, when you think it's past, seems like it's coming back at you. Are you with me? You can't read it. You can't monitor this kind of storm. Glory to God. There are many people right now that have been experiencing this cyclone. And many persons have seen you. And they don't even understand that you're battling against some storm. Are you with me, somebody? There are those of you right now that you experience all kinds of turbulences in your lives. And it seems like nothing is working out for you. There are those of you right now that are experiencing the family cyclone. When you think it's peace, oh good God Almighty, then suddenly something else arises. When you think that everything is all right, then it keeps coming back. When you think it has passed, the cyclone, it will take you and it will throw you there. And when you thought that it has left you, it's coming again. Are you with me? When you thought that it was over, here it comes again. There are many that have been experiencing this kind of storm, the cyclone. But hear me, I said, God is with you. Yes, Lord, you got to understand that you can't give up. I refuse to give up in the storm. I refuse for no storm to stop me. I charge you, I challenge you now. It doesn't matter what you're going through, ride out your storm, because God is with you. In the name of Jesus, I declare over your lives right now, in this time, ride out your storm. The reason why the devil is throwing these storms at you is because he understands you have a purpose, you have a destiny. The devil recognizes, hear me, sister, hear me, brother. The devil recognizes that you're on a mission. The devil recognizes that you're passing the worst. The devil recognize that victory is on the way. Can I declare this? In this year 2014, this year I prophesy that this year that God is going to bring you through. But you got to fight a little more. You can't give up now. God has spoken to me. And hear me, I said to each one of you right now that in this year, somebody say this year, go ahead, say this year, in this year, hear me, I want you to understand that God is about to work in your life. This year, I want you to take your calendar. As I prophesy to you now, he has spoken to me, the 7th, the 14th, the 21st, and the 28th of each month of this year. I want you to celebrate them as a day of thanksgiving, because God has already worked it out. Go ahead and give him thanks. You're not going down. The devil is a liar. No tornado is going to blow you away. The devil is a liar. No flood is going to wash you away. I declare this. It doesn't matter the cyclone that comes up against you. Ride out your storm. God is with you. In the name of Jesus, give him a praise. Go ahead and give God a praise. Hallelujah. Father, we bless your name. Father, we glorify you. Father, we magnify you. We exalt you. You are worthy right now to be exalted. Thank you, Father. The battle is on. My brothers and my sisters, my friends, all my friends and partners in the United States, Florida, Port St. Lucie, glory to God, in Fort Lauderdale, in West Palm Beach, in New York, Canada, England. Listen to me, those of you in Jamaica, I want you to get this word, because God has spoken. I want you to hear me this day. I want you to understand that you're in a warfare. Are you with me? God said in this year, 2014, God is going to bring deliverance and victory to your lives. But he said it's a year that you will have to battle. Healing is already yours. Deliverance is already yours. You'll already have the victory. Are you with me? Paul said, God shall supply all our needs. But can I tell you, it is not really God shall supply, but is that God has supplied all of your needs. The needs have already been supplied. All you've got to do is to give him thanks and praise. Give him thanks for it already. Because why does God said you should give thanks in all things? It is because God has already given it unto you. But you've got to start to activate and fight for that which God has already given to you. Are you with me? So one of the ways that you're going to release your faith is begin to give God thanks. Somebody say thanks. God said in this year, you should celebrate as a year of thanksgiving to God. I have told you already the dates that you ought to celebrate. But I want you to understand, we're going to fight, and the weapons that we're going to use to fight are not carnal weapons. Touch your neighbor and say, neighbor, you don't even understand that I'm in a warfare. Come on, touch your neighbor and say, neighbor, the battle is on. The battle is not yours, but the battle belongs to God. And I want you to understand in this year that God is about to bring you deliverance. But what you need is more of the anointing. Are you with me, somebody? In this year, it is the anointing that is going to destroy the yokes. Are you with me, somebody? Get ready. Are you ready? Right where you are, it doesn't matter where you are right now. You're listening to the man of God's voice. Whether you're driving in your cars or in your house, I am about to release the anointing right now upon you. I'm about to release an anointing upon you right now. I feel the Holy Ghost. Yes, I'm about to impart in your spirit. There is an anointing that is about to come upon you that is going to break every stronghold, that is going to break and destroy the yokes right now in the name of Jesus. Come on, I heard the writer declares, for the Spirit of the Lord God is upon me, for the Lord hath anointed me to preach good tidings unto the meek. He hath sent me to bind up the brokenhearted and to proclaim liberty to the captives and the opening of prison to them that are bound. Those who are mourning in Zion, I release an anointing upon you right now. An anointing to destroy, anointing to break the yoke. I release the anointing of praise on you. It is on you. Receive it now in the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord. Glory to God. He's on you. He's on your sister. Receive it now in the name of Jesus. Put on the garment of praise. Arm yourself. We're in a fight. We're in a fight. And this time we're going to take it by force. No storm is going to get you up. Come on. Put your garment on. Touch your neighbor and say, neighbor, Are you ready for the war? Yes, Lord. So neighbor, are you ready for the war? Are you ready for the war? There is power in the name of Jesus. Glory to God. There is power and deliverance. Come on, arm yourself. We're going out to war. We're going to go for our possession. In this year, God has spoken to me. God said that there are those of you that have been struggling in terms of clarity. There are some things that you've been struggling with, and you've been battling your storm for a while. But God said to tell you, in this year, God said He's going to make some things plain. Are you with me? Some of you that have been struggling concerning the will of God, God said, this year, I'm going to make it clear. God also says, there are those of you that have been getting some dreams. You've been getting some visions. Are you with me? You've gotten some good ideas also, and you've been sharing them with the wrong people, and they're messing you up. God said, stop sharing your vision. Stop sharing your dreams. God said, I'm about to make the vision clear. This year, are you with me? Are you with me, somebody? God said, that which the enemy meant for evil. God said, there are those of you who have been wrongfully accused, and as a result, you've been experiencing bad stuff in your life. God said, I'm about to turn it around for your good. There are seven things that God has spoken to me concerning this year that is going to release. You'll hear them on my next tape. Are you with me? The prophecy of 2014, you'll hear it. But I want you to understand, even now, I want you to arm yourself. Put on your praise. Put your praise on. And the praise that I'm talking about is the praise of thanksgiving. Hear me right now. The Bible said in 2 Chronicles, when the children of Israel was about to go to battle, the Bible said that three kings came up against Jehoshaphat, and they came to fight against him for no reason. The Bible said that Jehoshaphat became fearful, and he began to seek the Lord. Are you seeking the Lord concerning the many storms that you've been experiencing, my friend? And it seems the storms is getting worse. Hallelujah. I have a word for you. Jehoshaphat sought God in prayer and in fasting. The Bible said that the Lord spoke to him, and he said to him, the battle is not yours, but the battle belongs to God. He said, you want me to fight in this battle, but there's one thing that is required of you, is that when you get up tomorrow, you're going to gather the people together, and you're going to get the worshipers, and you're going to put them at the front of the battle, and let them sing praises unto me. Thanksgiving unto me. I told you before that he said, in all things you are to give him thanks, because it is the will of God. Are you ready to put on thanksgiving with me? Give thanks with a grateful heart. Psalm 100 and the verse 4. Enter the gates with thanksgiving, and into the courts with praise. Come on, right now, we're going out to battle. The devil is a liar. It doesn't matter the storm that you're experiencing right now. Hear me right now. You're going to go ahead and give God thanks. You may have just received a letter from the doctor, a doctor's report that you have cancer. Hear me right now. If God is saying that in all things, you must give him thanks. I want you to hold that report right now. I want you to look at that report right now. And I want you to declare that the doctor might say that I have cancer, but thank you, because God has already healed me. Can somebody go ahead right now and begin to give him thanks? Somebody give give him thanks. If you know you're healed already, give him the thanks. Somebody begin to give God thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. It doesn't matter what you're experiencing right now. Go ahead, put on the garment of thanksgiving and begin to give him thanks. Say thank you. Tell him thanks. Say thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. The billows may be rising. There may be trouble in my family, but I'm standing right now. I'm arming myself with thanksgiving, and I am saying thank you, Lord. Thank you. Somebody go ahead and give him thanks. Go ahead and give him thanks. Put on the garment of thanksgiving and release. Yes, release your thanks. Release. Thank you, Lord. Father, we give you thanks in this moment, in this hour. God, there are trouble around. You may have just lost your job. Cyclone of job lost. You're experiencing the storm right now. You just lost your job. But go ahead and say thank you. Yes, Lord, you're about to take Ayabakoturia. God has spoken to me while I was in Florida about houses. The Lord dropped it in my spirit just now. You're about to take your house. But God said, yes, yes, I'm about to bless you. Right now, somebody go ahead and thank him. The mortgage cannot be paid, and your house is in trouble. God said to go ahead and give him thanks. Somebody said, thank you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We're coming up against the storm, but we're saying thank you because Jesus is on board. He's on board. He's on board. Yes, glory to God. In all things give him thanks, for it is the will of God. On my prophetic praise CD, I have shared some things about praise. In closing this series, I want to share with you a testimony. The prophetic praise CD. God has used the CD. 1 week after I've done the prophetic CDs, there was a woman that they have worked witchcraft on. How the story went, I was in Spanish Town. While I was in Spanish Town, a gentleman called me across that was in a car. And when I went across to see him, and when I looked at him, tears were in his eyes. And there was a woman that was sitting beside him. One side of the woman's body was dead. The woman was dumb. She couldn't speak. And she also couldn't walk. And I asked him, what is wrong? He said to me that they have worked witchcraft on this woman and they needed help. I stood at the car door and I began to talk with them because I wanted to find out what really happened. Told me that the woman got up the morning, she was well, and all of a sudden she fell, struck with dumbness. One side of her body was dead. She couldn't walk. Couldn't lift a right hand. And I stood at the door because while I was doing this serious prophetic praise break, the devil tried to kill me in the studio. Locked the door. I had to kick the door off to get out. But God was preparing me for this. The devil recognized that there were some people that I would have been bringing deliverance to through these series and through the praise. Brothers and sisters, when the Lord reminded me of what the devil tried to do with me in the studio, I was hesitant at first while I was talking to these two persons. But when the Lord gave me the go-ahead, brothers and sisters, I pulled the door open and I locked myself with them in this car. I shut the door. I said, yes, you devil. I say, you try to kill me in the studio, but hear me, lock that door on me. But I shut the car door and I said, yes, it's me and you up in here today. You're not getting out. You try to kill me. Now we're going to go to war. And church of God, I locked that door and I said, yes, you ain't getting out. And the first word that came out of my mouth as I told them to let's go to war, I said, thank you, Lord. Yes, I said, you have a sign, your demonic agent against this woman. But I said, thank you, Lord. Glory to God. I begin to imagine in my mind, these people may be saying that this man is crazy, because how comes we called him to pray with us and he's here telling God thanks? But you don't understand, I was stepping up in the will of God, because he said, in all things you must give him thanks, because it is the will of God. And once you're in the will of God, there is nothing that you ask of God that shall be denied. He said, if you abide in me and my words abide in you, he said, you shall ask whatsoever you will and it shall be done. So I said, thank you. And after I was through giving thanks, I said, Lord, I just use my gate pass, because you need to understand, your gate pass to get up in the courts is thanksgiving. You do not see the king when you're at the gate. You only see the king when you get up into the courts. Are you with me? I said, God, no, I've just used my gate pass. So I said, give me pass. Let me get up in the courts. When I got up in the courts, I begin to say, give God praise. I begin to tell him, God, you're worthy. You deserve the glory. I said, God, you're the greatest. Dopitius. Hallelujah. I said, God, there is none like you. I said, demons has to surrender at your command. I begin to give him praise. Are you with me? He said, you should enter the gates with thanksgiving, and in the courts you must give him the praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And I begin to send up a praise. In the car, they begin to cry out. Hear the brother begin to cry out. And when I send up the praise, I said, God, I'm coming to you now to make my request known. I told you what attracts God is praise. Worship and pray. Hallelujah. God, I give you glory. I give you glory, God. I bless your name. I feel his presence even now. Glory to God. Hallelujah. 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 In a release, and after I was through releasing the praise, I begin to declare. I said, God, I'm coming to you now, because I've already given unto you what you deserve and what you desire. Then I begin to speak to the demons. I said, I don't know how long you've been orchestrating your plans. I don't know how long, but I said, it doesn't matter how long. I said, I don't know where you have sent these spirits from, whether down Westmoreland or down Negrilla. It doesn't matter where you've sent them from. I reverse every assignment and I send back every demonic assignment to descend, I begin to reverse every curse that has been assigned against this woman, and I begin to charge in the name of Jesus. I begin to declare the word that upon this rock you say you build a church and the gates of hell shall not prevail. I begin to bind up witchcraft and bind up sorcerer and bind up obiaman and witch doctor. I begin to reverse and to declare against every incantation and every words that have been spoken. I begin to reverse and declare and begin to speak the word back to God. I said, God, you said no weapon that is formed against us shall prosper. And I begin to declare the words back to God. And as I speak, the anointing came down in that car. I hear the young man cry out. I saw the woman begin to move. The anointing was in that car so heavily. And I hear when the young man stopped me, touched me, he said, "Preacher," with tears in his eyes, he said, "Preacher, pray for her because they have given her 7 days to live." And so I stopped immediately. And I said, "I'm not even going to pray another word." You know why? Because I said, every demon's just dead. I said, "You can't use the number 7. How can you mess with God and live?" No. I said, "They should have given that woman 6 days or 5 days or 2 or 3 or 8 days. I said, "How can you use the word 7? I said, "You just mess with God." I said, "Every demons that has been assigned against this woman, I said, I serve your notice." I said, "Get out in the name of Jesus." I said, "You just die 7 days." I stopped praying. I stopped declaring. Are you with me? Because I understand the word. When Nebuchadnezzar was trying to destroy the Hebrew boys, the mistake that he made, he said, "Heat the fire 7 times hotter." He never recognized what he was actually doing. He was pulling the presence of Almighty God into the midst of a fiery furnace. Are you with me, somebody? When that furnace was heated 1 time, God began to step down. 2 times, God began to step down even more. 3, 4, 5, by the heat, and at the 7th time, God was down in the fiery furnace. Are you with me, somebody? You cannot use 7. You mess with God. God has spoken to me. I told him that I'm not prophesying again. I'm not speaking another word. But what I did, I took my CD out, one of my CDs, and I said, "Listen, purchase the CD, because God has just brought me through a time of sickness that the devil tried to put all kind of things on me while I was doing this series. Sickness comes on me, emotional disturbances, and the final thing, he tried to kill me in the studio. Lock the door that no keys could open the door, and we never use a key. The engineer never used a key to lock the door, but when I was ready to come out, the door couldn't open. I had to kick it off. So get this CD, because there is an anointing that is on it that is going to bring deliverance to this woman." He took the CD in his hands and he looked at it and handed it back to me and drove away. People of God, in space of 15 minutes approximately, I saw the car drove back around where I was, and the car ripped into the little area where I was, and I saw the door swung open. He came out with the money in his hands, and he came to me and said, give me the CD, because he said, it is the first since this attack has come upon this woman. It is the first she has ever opened her mouth and talked to me and moved her hand. And it was when we left you. He said, something happened a while ago. I said to him, brother, this was what happened. I said, there are demonic elements that has been assigned against this woman. And when I locked myself in the car with her, when I locked myself, we begin to create an atmosphere that the demons was getting uncomfortable. Are you with me? Because anywhere there is praise, I tell you, God is going to show up. You will never get a scavenger, a drunkard, to leave the sky and come into your house. But can I tell you this? If you get dead meat and put it in your house and let it stay there for days and open that door, I guarantee you, you're going to get scavengers. They're going to leave from the heavens and they're going to come into your house. Are you with me, somebody? Because you're creating an atmosphere. If you want to see ants and flies begin to swarm your house, put down anything that is sweet. If you want to see bees, just put honey around and it will attract bees. Are you with me? What attracts God is your praise. If you want to see the glory of God show up in your house, in your church, in your life, just begin to give him some praise and you will see the glory. I said to him, that was what happened. We create an atmosphere that the spirits become uneasy. I gave him the CD and I said, play it in your car, play it in your house, play it day and night. Let it play right through the night. Create an atmosphere that will draw the glory and the presence of God. Because anywhere there is praise, God will show up. Are you with me? Glory to God. I feel like giving him a praise. I feel like giving him a praise. I feel like lifting my hands and giving him a praise. Is there anybody right now? You're listening this CD. Right where you are, just take a minute and say thank you. Just take a moment, hallelujah, and give him a praise right now. Hallelujah. Even now he's visiting you. Even now, if you're in the hospital, he's visiting you right now on that sick bed. As you give him the praise, he is visiting you. Hallelujah. And I said, watch God work, because praise is what will cause the changes. So as we praise him, he's going to come down. I tell him, go home. I said, when you go home, just begin to play the song and let the praises be released in the house. Because he deserved the glory. He deserved the honor. And he deserved all praise. That is what will move him. He went home and he followed my instruction. And church of God, the phone rang in approximately 3 hours. The guy's voice was so exciting. He said to me, he heard a screaming and a shouting in his room. And he said he got up, and when he went in, it was the woman that could not walk for 5 days, because the manifestation took place the Friday and I met them the Tuesday. That woman that could not walk since then, she was in the room with her hands lifted, crying out for Jesus, walking around. That woman, her hand could not move, her feet could not move, one of her foot could not move, the side of her face was twisted and she could not talk. In the space of approximately 3 hours, the praises begin to work. Are you with me? I told him, I said, listen, continue to release praises in the house, because the woman is going to get deliverance. The demons are still there, so continue to give praise. He called me back about 2 days after, and there was sadness in his voice, sadness with fear. You could hear the fear. I said, what's wrong? He said something strange is happening to the woman. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. But there's power in the name of Jesus. I said to him, what is happening right now? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. There's power in that. I said, listen, man, don't worry yourself. There is a wrestling that is taking place. He said, the woman told me there was something that was moving up and down in the woman's tummy. It was moving to the side and it was moving up and down like a ball was rolling in her tummy. The Spirit of the Lord spoke to me same time. And he said, tell him that what is happening with the woman, that there is a war that tell him that there is a war that is taking place. He said, tell him that the spirit of praise is raising up a standard against the assigned demons, and that spirit is getting uncomfortable. He said, tell him for the fact that you've been playing the CD in your house for days and nights, it's beginning to affect the atmosphere, and every demon that is in the atmosphere is getting uncomfortable. Are you with me? God said to tell him not to be afraid, because this woman is getting deliverance. He said, keep the praises on. He said, just tell him, don't be afraid, but just keep the praises on. Hallelujah. Because there is a wrestling, there is a war that is happening. Are you with me, somebody? Glory to God. There was a war that was raging. And I said, don't you be worried, because this woman is going to be free. Her deliverance is here. Church of God, I acted like I never even really cared for the rest of days. Never even called back the phone. The seventh day, which was the Friday morning, I woke up. And I took up the phone because I decided not to call until 7 days. The assignment that was assigned against the woman was from the Friday. And so it should have been this Friday, she should be dead. But I said, you're crazy. You can't mess with God. You can't mess with seven. You can't mess with God and live. Demons have to die. Yes, Lord. I took up the phone and I called him and I said, the first thing that I said, is she dead? He said, there the woman is delivered and well. He said, there is no sign. She's walking, she's talking, she's functioning right. Nothing in her body, nothing moving. I said, yes. So he said, the only thing that is happening with the woman, she has fear, and I am fearful also. I said to him, that's all right. I said, let me take out the medicine book, the book that gives me information how to deal with the many issues. I said to him, listen to me. Let me give you the cure for fear. 2 Timothy chapter 2, I think verse 7. I said, every morning you wake, take this pill, take this. And every night you go to bed, take it. For God has not given unto you the spirit of fear, but of love and power and of a sound mind. I say, take this. Church of God, I left and went to Barbados. I spent 3 months and came back. As I came back, I took up the phone and I called him and I said, is the woman well? He said, the woman is still well. But the woman left me. I said to him, you'll have to work that one on all yourself. I said, I don't have a cure for that one. Good God Almighty, I said, you'll have to work that one on. God is a good God, church. If you continue to give him praise, I challenge you in this time, in this season, that your storm, we're going to praise God through the storm. My other series two, you can't afford to miss series two. And this series is one of the most essential series, because it is not so much about the storms. Because as long as we're alive, the storms, they're going to come. But hear me, There are some wounds and some things that have been left, that the storm has left you hurting. Katrina passed, and after many years, there are many that have not recovered as yet. They can't miss getting part two after the storm, that is. Come and share with me and hear what I have to say to you about after the storm. Because those of you that have been gone through the storm, nobody, because they have not seen the wounds, they think that you're not wounded. They have not seen the blood, so they don't know you're bleeding. They are not hearing the cries, so they don't even hear you crying. Many are not sensitive enough to realize that you're wounded, that the storms has left you wounded. But hear me right now. Hallelujah. Lord, you're welcome in this place. Have your way. Come on, somebody, give him the praise. Lord, you are welcome in this place. Lord, you are welcome in this place. Lord, you are welcome in this place. Have your way. Come on, tell him right now, heal and deliver. Heal and deliver in this place. Heal and hallelujah, hallelujah. Heal and deliver in this place. Have your way. Join with me in part two after the storm. It will be a blessing to your hearts. Give him thanks. There is power in the name of Jesus. Somebody go ahead and give him praise right now. Lord, we give you thanks. We give you thanks. I want to take this time out also to acknowledge a few persons. There are many persons that I want to acknowledge. First of all, my family, wonderful family, my wife and my two daughters, my mother, my mother-in-law, my brother, my sister, my family, my musicians, and engineer. I want to acknowledge them, partners and friends in the United States, those persons who I have met while I was in West Palm Beach. Oh my God, the Douglas's family, the brethren at the Douglas's church, partners with me at Pastor Chambers Church. Oh good God Almighty, at Sister Ingrid's church, and there are other ministries around. My good friend that I'm now partnershiping with, Pastor Evangelist Nash, good God Almighty, and wonderful people of God, my good friend, glory to God, my wonderful friend, Sister Ingrid. Also want to make mention of Bishop Jackson, right there in Port St. Lucie, wonderful man of God. He has been opening many doors for me in the United States, and I want to give God thanks for him. Glory to God. There are so much, I don't want to call too many names because I might miss some and you feel bad. But all my wonderful friends, my friends in Jamaica, my partners all over, those who have supported Prophetic Praise Break 2, and I know you're going to be supported. You have been blessed, and I know everyone that has purchased my CD, you have been blessed. Thanks for the contribution, for the support, and watch out, look out, I'm coming back at you. Remember, I'm here. Book me in your church. God has been opening doors in my life. Glory to God. Book me in your church. God bless you. Say yes. Give God a praise. Somebody go ahead and give God a praise. Give him a praise. Say thank you. Come on, say thank you. Say thank you. Go ahead and say thank you. God bless you. God bless you.